Good afternoon and welcome to the graduation ceremony for the Fort Atkinson High School class of 2021. At this time, I would ask you to please stand, remove your hats, face the flag, and please join us in the singing of our national anthem. At this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our first speaker for the day, Mr. Corey Pfeiffer.
Hello, class of 2021. 4 years have come and gone. I don't know about you all, but I still feel like a freshman. Time has really flown by. And now, here we are, seniors on the verge of moving on in life. In just a few short months, we'll all be in different places. Some of us are staying home. Some of us are going to college. Some of us overseas. We knew this moment was coming, but we didn't realize how soon it would actually come. With everything we've gone through and the many different paths that we're taking, it's fitting to see our journey together temporarily rest in one place, right here at Fort Atkinson High School. Throughout the graduation ceremony today, I hope you all can make some lasting memories of your peers. Use today to think back on your years at Fort Atkinson High School. Think about the good and the bad. I cannot say enough how proud I am to call you all my classmates. Seeing us all grow as individuals and as a group these past few years has been incredible. Every one of you sitting in front of me has the tools to build a lasting legacy in whatever endeavors you may pursue. Reflect on today and then use it to build towards tomorrow. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce our next speaker, Ava Clemen.
This year, the class of 2021 has had the privilege to host three foreign exchange students from around the world. They have become a part of our community as students, athletes, and friends. We wanted to give each of them a chance to share some of their experiences with you to show how moving to Fort Atkinson for a little less than a year has impacted their lives. At this time, I'd like to introduce our foreign exchange students, starting with Justin Chen.
My name is Justin Chen, and I am an exchange student from Taiwan. During this year, I have been through so many unique and amazing experiences during the span of this journey. I was overwhelmed by the unique and foreign environment at first. However, I slowly became accustomed to a life of a high school student here and enjoyed every day I'm here. I met a lot of friendly teachers and amazing friends, and I also get to experience classes and lessons that I will remember for a lifetime. I'm intrigued by the shorter school day, which allows us to participate in extracurricular activities. During this year, I attended the basketball, soccer, and track team, and I'm really glad I did. We competed with other schools and faced obstacles that we overcame as a team. The coaches are supportive, allowing us to constantly enhance and fine-tune our abilities. The most memorable moment this year is the last home game near the end of soccer season. On that day, the weather was chilly, and we lost by a small lead of 1-0. However, that game demonstrated the most teamwork and dedication I've ever seen. Even with this year is chaotic, with lots of twists and turns, it has still been an astounding year. Although COVID happened, this unique and amazing voyage made me truly understand the feeling of being an American culture. I'm extremely grateful for everything my host family has done this year. Finally, I thank you all for being part of my journey and experience as an exchange student, and I hope I can meet you all once again someday. Thank you for your time.
I'd like to invite Francesca up to the stage, please.
Good afternoon, Fort Atkinson. For the ones who don't know me, my name is Francesca Shan, and I've been an exchange student from Italy here in Fort for the past 10 months. Exactly 1 year ago, I was asked to make the toughest decision of my life. The COVID-19 pandemic had just started in Italy, and it was really bad. They asked a 16-year-old girl, "Hey, are you sure you want to go to the opposite part of the world for 10 months alone in the middle of a pandemic?" And I said, "Yeah, sure." Well, I lied. I wasn't sure of anything. And now you may be wondering how at the end I made this crucial decision which was going to completely change my future. Easy. I did what everyone in my same situation would do. I flipped a coin. But that's not the point. The important thing is that I made a decision. And I promised myself that I would never look back till the very end. And now, here we are, at the end. These past 10 months have been the best one of my life. Not because they've always been easy, but because I achieved my goal, and I say even beyond. I personally have always been interested in other cultures. I'm a believer, and I'll never stop believing that if we want to make this world a better place, we have to get to know each other. I consider values like diversity, adaptability, cooperation, respect, fundamental in order to make our own little steps toward this goal, which for me is vital. I grew up so much this year, And I'm so thankful that now I can say that I know the world a little bit better. I didn't come here with the intention of comparing my country with yours, but with the only hope, which was more like uncertainty, to be able to learn a new point of view, to adapt to a new and different reality, and to use the outstanding personal enrichment in my future, not only for myself, but hopefully for others too. Because of this, I feel extremely lucky to have had the privilege of being one of you Blackhawks, at least for 1 year. I want to thank this amazing community who welcomed me from the very first day I came here, and that now I'm proud to call home. My family who never missed the chance to make me feel loved like a daughter and a big sister. But most importantly, today I want to thank you, students and staff from the Fort Atkinson High School. You made this year feel like a dream. I found friends and mentors who I'll never forget, and that hopefully will be long life friendships. You all are part of this, which inspired and taught me so much about the world as well as about myself. I can barely recognize myself now. But at the end, the exchange year is not a year in one life, right? It's a life in 1 year. I just don't want to leave. I'm not ready. And for the ones who are wondering, yes, I miss eating pasta and pizza every day. But I have to admit that Dunkin' Donuts and Pizza Hut were pretty good too. Always and forever, let's go Blackhawks. Grazie mille.
For our final foreign exchange, we have Baptiste Villard.
My name is Baptiste Villard, and I'm 18 years old, and I come from France. I decided to come to the United States to learn English, meet different people, and to grow up before I enter in college. I made this decision very late. It was around June 2020, and I don't regret anything at all because now I learn how to speak English, even though I know I still have a navy French accent. So I hope you can understand me. And I've met a lot of amazing people. First of all, my host family. I thank them for everything they have done for me and for introducing me to the American culture. I know it isn't easy to host a stranger, but I hope it was a good experience for them because it was an amazing experience for me. Thank you to Fort Atkinson High School for letting me have this experience despite COVID happening. It has been an amazing part of my chapter. I hope every student here has an amazing life, succeed in life, and have amazing opportunity. God bless America and Fort Atkinson High School and everyone here.
Goodbyes are always hard. They are full of tears, I'll miss yous, and hugs when it is in a pandemic. So, although your time with us is nearly up, on the behalf of the class of 2021, I would like to thank you. Each of you opened our minds and gave us a chance to experience a taste of your home as we welcomed you to ours. I hope that Fort Atkinson, Wisconsin, and the United States has become your home away from home. Here is a gift from our class in order to remember your time here. We wish you the best of luck with your future as you continue to live and learn. And we know that this goodbye is simply the next step in order to say hello again later on. We will miss each of you and hope that you will keep in touch. Safe travels. And now it is my pleasure to introduce our faculty speaker, Mr. Michael Hall.
Thank you. And good afternoon. For those of you who don't know, I'm Mike Hall, an English teacher here at Fort Atkinson High School. I'd like to begin by humbly thanking Mr. Halverson, Dr. Abbott, Board of Education, and you guys, the class of 2021, for allowing me to speak today. This is truly an honor. I'd also like to welcome all the parents, other relatives, and friends who are here to share this special day. In fact, I'd like you to recognize your family, which could simply mean your mother and father, or just your mother, or just your father. It could mean step-parents or grandparents or family friends. Whatever family means to you, let's take the time to stand and give them a hand. Class of 21, stand up and give your family a hand. Thank you. If you stop to think for even a few moments, it may seem impossible to ever truly thank them for all they've done for you. Not to worry. Paying them back isn't as difficult as it seems. It's simple, really. Move out. Maybe not this afternoon, but eventually, move out. Until then, keep your room clean. And occasionally think about cleaning the bathroom, will ya? Amen, right, parents? Amen. I'd also like to recognize all those graduating seniors who are entering the military. Those enlisted military graduates, please stand when you hear your name. Sam Lysias, Air Force. Abigail Punzel, Navy. Dorian Burhans, Marines. Alexis Jacobson, National Guard. Jacob Horvaten, National Guard. Sky Hayes, National Guard. Eli Kaler, National Guard. Why these people deserve this recognition can simply be explained from a line by Aaron Sorkin. They deserve our respect because they stand on a wall and say, nothing's going to hurt you tonight, not on my watch. They don't do this because someone told them to do it. They do it because it's important to them. How about another round of applause for these students? Thank you. This is an extra special graduation, not just for you, but also for me. This year, I'm graduating with you. Yeah, go ahead, that's fine. It's taken me a little longer, but we're all going together. Needless to say, we've all endured an unbelievable 15 months. It's certainly been a year of loss. Some of us have lost family members or friends. Many of us have lost countless opportunities that were afforded to so many people before us. As much as I find myself thinking of all we've lost, I'm beginning to focus on all the things we've learned. Now, Many people today, either from this stage or during a graduation party, are going to provide you with inspirational words of wisdom. They're going to be grabbing this podium or holding a paper plate full of potato salad and saying things like, "Well, if you want to get ahead, you really should, dot, dot, dot." It may not be those exact words, but the sentiment will be the same. My only humble piece of advice is to take all of that with a grain of salt. What I've discovered over the last year or so is that most adults don't always have the answer. And here's my evidence. Toilet paper. Toilet paper. Are you kidding me? We're going to build extra sheds out back so we can stock up on toilet paper? Let's just say that sometimes adults' thinking goes into the ditch just like yours does. Instead of pontificating about all I think I know after 35 years of teaching, I'm simply going to point out the things that I've learned from you. Your generation, especially you seniors, have taught the world things to which the rest of us should sit up and pay attention. The first lesson you've taught the rest of us has everything to do with resilience. You've endured hardships that no other senior class could even imagine. Some of you are potential scholarship athletes, and you've been robbed of opportunities to show the world your athletic talents. Some of you have gone from working part-time, a part-time job, to being the major income of your family. Some of us adults sincerely can't even fathom that reality. The second lesson I've learned from you centers around the idea that mental and emotional well-being means so much more than a standardized test score or a state report card. It may be years before we truly know the impact of being stuck inside our homes, learning on a laptop, but you've made us realize that whether it be in person or virtually, we should always focus on how someone is feeling before worrying about what they know. As much as we want to highlight and foster academic growth, you have taught us that unless we pay attention to mental and emotional stability, grammar, stoichiometry, and derivatives don't mean a thing. Your ability to see this and show the rest of the world has much to do with what comes next. The third and most valuable lesson I've learned from you guys may just change the world. To give this context, I have to give a mini history lesson that I read from author David Brooks. For the first half of the 20th century, societies had to survive a similar pandemic, world wars, the Great Depression, and the Red Scare. This created the communal mentality that we're all in this together. As it created great unity, it also fostered things like bigotry and racism. That dramatically changed in the 60s and 70s as a result of the civil rights struggle, the women's movement, and speaking truth to governmental power. Our society suddenly became the me generation. This sparked individuality, civil liberty rights, and creativity. Unfortunately, this me-first mentality has also developed a loss of purpose and isolationism. The soaring statistics of suicide and opioid addiction are flashing warning signs of this egocentric mindset. It only stands to reason, then, that the next societal wave has become tribalism. groups gathering up the lost souls, treading in a sea of uncertainty, and creating almost a gang mentality, us against them. Most people, when asked, say they don't necessarily like their political party, but they definitely hate the other party. Those who have stirred up the populist tribal movement love to stoke that binary temperament. And it doesn't take long to get swept up in that attitude. Life is easier to deal with if things are simply good or bad, right or wrong, our way or their way. As many of us know, life just isn't that simple. But here's where you guys come in. You may not have a solid grasp of the last 100 years of societal shifts, but over that last year, many, if not all of you, have sharpened your already keen emotional awareness. This is hugely important. Some of you don't even know you have this in you, but many of us see it. This approach has helped you understand the dangerous flaws of hyper-individualism and dubious tribal attitude. Because of your experience of the last year or so, you guys have solidified the don't leave anyone behind mentality. I've seen it time and time again with your generation, especially those of you sitting here today. Instead of running around like headless chickens yelling me, 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 or collectively yelling us, 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 you have turned society on its ear and learned the ultimate importance of looking back to see who has been left behind. When you suspect someone is struggling at home, you ignore CDC guidelines to make sure that person's all right. You know the sting of loneliness and the false allure of mob mentality. Your compassion that has been tempered by a long, arduous struggle forces you to look out for people around you. You're not all about as long as I'm okay or as long as we're okay. You've reminded me and the rest of the toilet paper hoarding adults that the importance lies not in as long as we're okay, but in the question, who's still not okay? With this attitude, we fortify a renewed sense of purpose and a genuine feeling of unity by believing in the words of David Brooks, I commit to you. Here's the best part. You've done this. Not some sage in an oversized robe on a stage. We're learning this from you. Whatever you do, don't let this great opportunity wither on the vine now that we're headed toward the light and now that you're changing your environment. Please, don't wait for 60 and 70-year-old men to set your generation's policies. The next great movement will be authored and facilitated by you, the young. How you perceive the world and how well you teach the rest of us will truly transform the world. I'm humbled that I've been asked to speak today, and I consider myself fortunate to have taught and coached you and many of your parents during these 30 years. A fortunate few devote themselves to occupations as rewarding as this. I've watched so many of you and those before you grow into wonderful human beings. Nothing could be more gratifying. If you're lucky, the career to which you eventually commit won't be something you do. It'll be something you become. Thank you again, and I wish you all the best in the future. Like most days, this is a great day to be a Blackhawk.
15 months and I still can't get my glasses not to steam. Good afternoon. On behalf of the School District Fort Atkinson Board of Education District Administration, it is indeed a pleasure to welcome graduates, parents, family, teachers, and friends as we join together to recognize the end of a 13-year journey. Our seniors moving on to the next chapter in what I am quite certain will be impactful lives. Beyond our graduates, I believe that it's important for me to recognize the district staff who have worked tirelessly over these many years to help our students develop the social, emotional, academic, and vocational skills that they need to succeed as they move their tassels from one side of the mortarboard to the other. And I give each staff member a very heartfelt thank you for all they have done in making our district what it is and in helping our learners see who it is they can and who they will be. Would you please join me in thanking them with a round of applause? I'm guessing when you started this year, you had some preconceived notions as to how it would go. And of course, let's be honest, this last year and a half has not gone as we've expected to in any conceivable way. And I'm talking beyond the microcosm of our school district here in Fort Atkinson. Surely, we are living in a cliche of expecting the unexpected. Believe it or not, these experiences will, in fact, serve you well in your future. Graduation, like today, is a transition. It's a time of change, and it places you in a position of immense opportunity. I encourage you to take a bit of an inventory of the supports or the people you go to when challenges pop up. And in most cases, your family, which of course can be defined in many, many different ways, has been and remains your go-to. Your support system. These are the people that you don't necessarily appreciate nearly enough because you know they care about you no matter what. Your family is who you go to when you need a little guidance, need to admit a little help is needed, or you want a guaranteed cheerleader. And then there's your friends. Friends can be a vital source of support in the years that lie ahead. With graduation comes the opportunity of new relationships as others may change over time. Be open to those who you choose to surround yourself with. They need to be a source of support, a source of laughter, a source of motivation, and a source that helps you reach your ever-heightening goals. No one knows you better than you, of course, and if all goes well, the experiences you choose for yourself will enable you not just to continue to grow, but to flourish, each in your own individual way. You know your dreams, you know your goals, and you know your vision for where it is that you want to go. Be unwavering in what you value and what you know is right for yourselves. Advocate for your needs to find the success that you deserve. I was recently working with some graduate students, and one asked what I believe had been the biggest change over the last year or so. And it really gave me pause to think and reflect just for a moment, but I responded with one single word, and that word was civility. Somewhere along the line, we have lost the ability to talk without shouting, to listen without a need to convince, to hear in efforts to synthesize dichotomy, and to consider context before engaging. Thoughts, emotions, words, and actions, they float in our air instantaneously, and of late, more often than not, without consideration of civility, without a desire for dialogue or true discourse, but instead to convince, or to demand, or to put down. I wonder if there'll be a correction, if there will be a pause, a breath, or a recentering in efforts to recount the societal gains that we have made with simple acts of civility that did not require prior planning. It is simply how we acted, but more importantly, how we interacted. It is my hope that your generation seeks just that type of reset, to be interested in divergent ideas and ideologies with curiosity and generosity. Please, graduates, be part of re-civilizing our civilization. Things are different. Things are certainly not the same. Things will be forever altered. The difference is your power to be part of who we become in the future. Take your Black Hawk pride and show the world what it is you can do, who you can be, and where you can take us. Our world is and will be an increasingly complicated place, and while you cannot change it by yourselves, you can have a significant impact if you choose to. You will forever be part of our One Fort family. We are one team, one district, and one community. And with that, I offer my heartfelt congratulations and my very best wishes for the years that lie ahead. Work hard. Prepare to learn from your failures. Celebrate those people who support you. And never forget that you will always have a One Fort Black Hawk home. My congratulations to our graduates, the class of 2021. It's my pleasure next to introduce our student speakers, Aiden McDonough, Ava Kleeman, and Madison Miles.
Hi, I'm Ava Kleeman.
I'm Maddie Miles.
What's up? I'm Aiden McDonough.
As everyone walks out of this gym today, we will encounter a new road trip. Whether it takes us like a road trip, none of us are sure exactly of what it will look like.
And road trips aren't meant to be cheap, so parents, look out. There's a long road ahead of you guys.
In 4 years, obviously there's been road bumps for all of us. Whether it's failing our stupid e-contests,
crying in AP bio,
or finishing an essay right before it's due.
Or even last year's homecoming game, where going for two rather than just kicking the extra point kind of cost us the game.
So yeah, it's been pretty bumpy.
No matter how bumpy it's been, the good times outweigh the rest. In the last 12 years, I've had the privilege of being friends with many of my fellow classmates. Through field trips, assemblies, and extracurricular activities, I have been blessed to get to know many of you and grow alongside you. Some of you I would have never been friends with if it wasn't for the clubs. All of these activities within school and out have influenced all of us to go down the paths of our choice. But we can't forget who helped us along the way.
I can honestly say that I've been blessed to be a part of the Fort Atkinson School District for the last 13 years. Throughout my time in Fort Atkinson, I've been granted many opportunities by this community. Growing up, organizations like the Parks and Rec Department, Boys and Girls Club, the Fort Aquatic Center, and GATE have all provided us places to learn and express ourselves. These programs and many others have guided our road trip this far and will continue to do so for younger generations. I'd like to extend my gratitude to all the teachers, administration, and support staff at the high school for helping me and my fellow classmates pursue our dreams. The senior class and I are thankful for all your help and support, especially throughout the adversity we have experienced in the last year or so. As a graduating senior, I want to advise the future Fort Atkinson graduates to reach out to teachers, counselors, and support staff at the high school to help you through your years. All these people have your back. They love you, respect you, and they want to see you succeed and reach your full potential. To all the graduates today, don't forget your roots. The same people who have had your back in the last 4 years will continue to do so for the rest of your road trip, if you so choose.
With that, I'm sure we would all be glad to keep things moving as we continue down our different paths. We have formed our own goals and ideas, exemplifying our growth from the start of our freshman year. Whether we like to admit it or not, being in school has taught us much more than just academics. We've learned how to challenge ourselves, form relationships with the people around us, and much, much more. As a result, our class is far more unique. We have more people joining the workforce, entering the military, and looking towards various extensions of further education. I know we've all got big plans for after high school, and I'm confident we'll find success down our separate ways.
Now it is time for us to part ways, but don't forget to take a look back and remember who you grew up alongside with. These people sitting next to you will be the ones supporting you, no matter what. We were all there for each other's first big milestone, graduation. This will be remembered for the rest of our lives, and just take a moment to congratulate yourselves. You have earned this. It's now time to go on a road trip. Congratulations, class of 2021. It is my pleasure to introduce our next speaker, Mr. Dan Halverson.
Hang in there, everybody. We're almost done into the good part, all right? You know, when I started writing this speech, I was reminded of what a good friend once told me after sitting too long through one of my other gabatory speeches. He said, keep it simple and short. Now that I think more about it, he said, I think, keep it short, stupid. They're not here to see you. They're here to see these wonderful people in front of you, I think was his exact words, so I'll do just that. I'm going to take this one last time to impart one more nugget, or as Mr. Hall calls it, words of wisdom, to each of you as you move on to what's next. This time, it won't just be me saying these things, though. I'm going to reference a lot of other very famous, hardworking people that, just like you, started off in seats that you're sitting in today. It's pretty simple, actually, and all these people boiled it down to one word. No matter what it is you choose to do, no matter where you end up, lead. Regardless of your status as a graduate, regardless of where you come from, who you are, where you're going, each and every one of you have the potential to be a great leader and positively impact the world in which we all share. Charles Boss Kettering was an American inventor, engineer, businessman, and the holder of 186 patents, and said, there exist limitless opportunities in every industry. When there is an open mind, there will always be a frontier. As you move forward after today, take that to heart. Challenge those next frontiers. Don't just guess at what success is. Think it through, figure it out, and do what it takes every single day to be successful. No one really cares how tired you may be, how hard you have worked before, what you look like, or where you come from. They care about what you're doing now to take care of what's in front of you or them that needs to be done. Be that person that others look to and can count on. Follow when necessary, but take charge and lead whenever possible. Don't just settle. What you think might be pretty awesome to you, or you know, something you might be proud of, might not cut it where you're going. Don't just settle. Again, take charge and lead through. How about this one? John D. Rockefeller, American business magnate and philanthropist who's widely considered the wealthiest American of all time and the richest person in modern history, he said it best when he told everyone, don't be afraid to give up the good to go for the great. Yep, you're going to be afraid. Yep, you're going to fail. Yep, people might not care for you sometimes, but do what you feel is right and go for it. You've all heard me say this before, no matter what it is you choose to do, your goal should be the best at whatever that is for your future. Lead the way. Last but not least, I'm going to leave you with this. As you choose a career, possibly one that hasn't even been created yet, I might add, do what makes you happy. If you love what you do, you'll never work a day in your life is a great adage many of you have heard me say before. Whatever it is, though, take the lead and remember the words of Woodrow Wilson, who said, you are not here merely to make a living. You are here in order to enable the world to live more amply, with greater vision, with a finer spirit of hope and achievement. You are here to enrich the world, and you impoverish yourself if you forget the errand. Lead. One word, one nugget, and one path to your success. Congratulations to every single one of you. We're proud of you, we're happy for you, and we wish you all nothing but the best. Members of the Board of Education, Superintendent Abbott, distinguished guests, and all present. As principal of Fort Atkinson High School, I submit that the students seated before you have met all academic program requirements established by the School District of Fort Atkinson and by the Department of Public Instruction for the state of Wisconsin, and are therefore eligible for diploma presentation at this time. Yeah.
Ellen Sherrell honors with a silver cord. Olivia Granick, high honors, gold cord. Aiden McDonough, high honors, gold cord. Corey Pfeiffer, honors, silver cord. Brooke Liebman, high honors, gold cord. Mariah Eichenberg, honors, silver cord. Jacob Blanchard. Baptiste Ballard.
With honors, receiving a silver cord, Louis Luciano. With honors, receiving a silver cord, Ava Clemen. With high honors, receiving a gold cord, Tyler Batansky. With high honors, receiving a gold cord, Matthew Batansky. With honors, receiving a silver cord, Mary Ellen Moran. Receiving high honors and a gold cord, Emma Manns. Ashton Tessman. Andrew Glish.
With honors and receiving a silver cord, Noah Frame. With high honors and receiving a gold cord, Angela Unate. With high honors and receiving a gold cord, Lauren Haas. Michaela Pennywell. Fighting soul, With honors and receiving